Anime fans, One Piece fans, what is good? The answer to that question, of course, is One Piece. One Piece is what's good. And today we're going to be talking about why Luffy has to defeat Kaido 1v1. So this video isn't about how Luffy will beat Kaido necessarily 1v1, but why he will beat Kaido 1v1. And I know a lot of people are not believers in this, and they say it's going to have to be an alliance, a team who fights Kaido. The level of Yonko is too far beyond Luffy, especially with how Kaido one-shot Luffy. But no, I tell you, Luffy will defeat Kaido 1v1, or at least he will be Yonko level at the end of this arc. At the end of the Wano arc, he will be Yonko level. Whether he defeats Kaido 1v1, or Big Mom 1v1, or somebody we haven't thought of 1v1, he's going to defeat someone who's Yonko level and become Yonko level himself. And since Kaido is the face of this arc, and Kaido is the main antagonist, Kaido should be the one that Luffy takes down 1v1, and I am pretty staunch on that. I do not see any way Luffy won't defeat Kaido 1v1. And even if it's not Kaido, like at least Big Mom, or something like that, he has to defeat someone Yonko level 1v1. And it probably is going to be Kaido, just because of the role Kaido has in this arc, and I have many reasons for saying this. So the first reason is just kind of straightforward. Luffy has always defeated the villain 1v1, or at least been stronger than the villain at the end of the arc, if it's kind of a normal arc. Because I know some of you might say Doflamingo, but I don't care if Law helped Luffy. At the end of Dressrosa, Luffy was stronger than Doflamingo. That was indicated. And I know that people are like, no, he wasn't. Doflamingo was hurt from Gamma Knife. But just looking at it, Gamma Knife or not, when Luffy was in Gear 4th, he steamrolled Doflamingo. He stomped on Doflamingo. Doflamingo could do nothing. The only problem was the time limit. But Gear 4th itself was out of Doflamingo's league considerably. So yes, Luffy was stronger than Doflamingo, in my opinion. Always was since the beginning of the time skip, because he had Gear 4th since the beginning of the time skip. So with the villains, you know, Crocodile, Enel, Hody Jones, just Luffy always beats them 1v1 and comes out on top. So I don't see why Oda would change the memo, change how the series works just for Wano, because it's on a bigger scale. Luffy is an overcomer. It doesn't matter who his opponent is. He does not care that Kaido is a Yonko. He doesn't care that Kaido is out of his league at the moment. Luffy will surpass that and he will overcome, because that's what he does. That's who he is. And I don't believe that the strength of Kaido is any reason for the fans to think that Luffy can't defeat Kaido 1v1 by the end of Wano. Of course he can't now. He's definitely too weak now, but he's going to have to do that, because this kind of ties into my next reason. There are two Yonkos in Wano right now. You got Big Mom and you got Kaido. How do the Alliance hope to get over that if none of them are even close to Yonko level? How do you expect to defeat two Yonkos, potentially more people, if you can't even take like two first hands at the same time? You know what I'm saying? If the first hands of Kaido's army and Big Mom's army are as strong as the strongest person in the Alliance, what hope does the Alliance have? Luffy is going to have to become Yonko level if he expects to take them out. But that's not it. Wano is going to be on a scale we have not seen before. Like, this thing is going to make Marineford look like a baby walk, according to Oda. And that is a lot, because Marineford had two Yonkos, 100,000 Marines, you got all three Admirals, you got a Yonko level Fleet Admiral, you got tons of famous pirates who were under Whitebeard, you got warlords. Wano's going to be bigger than that. It's going to make Marineford look like a baby field. So that means you're probably going to have a lot of warlords, you're going to have a ton of famous pirates, you're going to have a ton of Marines, you're probably going to have all three Admirals, you're probably going to have at least three Yonkos, even though some people argue that Luffy counts as a Yonko. And I do believe Luffy counts as a Yonko, but I'm pretty sure that saying that Wano will be on a bigger scale than Marineford means that you're going to have even more than just Luffy counting as the third Yonko. So it's going to be on a ginormous scale, and a ton of allies and enemies we have not foreseen are going to show up. And Luffy, on his side, he is going to be the face of his side, because this isn't going to be like Marineford, even though it's it's been compared to Marineford. Luffy is not going to be the weak one again. He learned his lesson in Marineford. He's not going to be the weak one. He is going to be on the top of this alliance this time. In this war, Luffy is going to be at the forefront of it and not as a rambunctious, bold kid. He's not going to be a bold weakling anymore. He's going to be a confident powerhouse who has the ability to fight at the front of it. He's going to be one of the strongest, if not the strongest, of his alliance. He's going to be in the top tiers of his side. It's not going to be like Marineford, because he already basically swore that would never happen again. He's not going to do that. So when Wano comes to a head, Luffy is going to be one of the top tiers, and he can't do that. He can't be one of the top tiers in this war, in this giant war to come, if he's not Yonko level, if he can't duke it out with Kaido, if he can't perform in a battle against the top tiers. He's not going to be one of the top tiers, and he's got to be one of the top tiers. He just has to. Oda wouldn't backtrack like that, you know what I'm saying? And then this arc also is probably going to signify the end of an era, because we know Marineford was supposed to be the end of an era, but I kind of consider this era an intermediate era, right? You still got a lot of the old generation. I believe that Big Mom and Kaido are going to fall in the Wano arc, and possibly even somebody like Shanks, and it's going to completely launch the era of Blackbeard, Luffy, Kid, because I believe that Kid will ascend to the top of the era along with Luffy. I know some people don't believe with that, but I'm sure all of us have heard this. I think Kid is Luffy without plot armor, so I believe like he and Luffy are going to ascend to the top of this era, and then they're going to be with Blackbeard and all that stuff. I believe that the old eras are going to finally crash, and their legends will end in Wano. And as I said, that cannot happen if Luffy is not Yonko level. That just is not going to happen. And again, I'm not sure how he will, and I don't know if it's going to be plot armored. It probably will be, but it's going to happen, because I don't see how it couldn't happen. And then my next reason is One Piece is supposed to end in 5 years. I made a video, my last video is about why that actually could happen, because Lady Toki was born in the Void Century most likely, and she's going to know what happened, and that probably means that the Straw Hats are going to learn the truth of the Void Century, and that's going to become a funnel that explodes into the end of this series. I believe it's going to be Wano, then Raftel, then the Final War, maybe a little bit of stuff in between those three events, but that's going to be the gist of it. That's going to be the bulk of the next 5 years. Wano Raftel War, or Wano Raftel One Piece War, and Luffy's going to have to power up fast, because I know some people just forget this, but Luffy has to surpass Roger. He said he would. He's the main character. That's like the goal of the series, to find One Piece and surpass Roger, and he can't do that if he's not Yonko level, especially when One Piece is running out. The time of One Piece is running out. He's got to surpass Roger soon. Like, he's gotta. Roger was the strongest. He was the pirate king. How is Luffy going to be near that? How is he going to get to the level of pirate king if he's not even Yonko level after Wano? How? That just doesn't make any sense to me. He's going to have to do that, because it's been so long. The Straw Hats are still so weak. The Straw Hats need to become a Yonko level crew and fast, and then Luffy will ascend beyond that, at least if you do believe that pirate king is above Yonko, which I do believe it is. Like, the Straw Hats are going to have to become the strongest crew that has ever been seen by the world. I believe that they're even going to be stronger, just slightly stronger, than Whitebeard and Roger, because they're the main characters, and that's what the series is kind of about. One Piece is ending so soon that they need to get up to par. They need to get their performance up. They need to become the strong ones. They gotta get on the level of the top tiers before they can ascend past the top tiers. And if One Piece has like 5 years left, they gotta do it now. So that's what I'm saying. I'm saying Wano, the Straw Hats, Luffy specifically, need to ascend. They need to ascend to the top, and Luffy can't do that if he's not becoming Yonko level. He can't be the face. He can't be in the ranks of the strongest. He can't be in the top tiers of the coming Wano War, which is going to make Marineford look like nothing. So that's, as I said, means more than two Yonkos, like at least 100,000 Marines, or maybe not at least 100,000 Marines, but like tons of Marines, tons of famous pirates, warlords, Yonkos. Like, it's going to be huge, and Luffy's not going to be the weak one. As I've said, as I've reiterated so many times, he's not going to be the weak one again. He's going to be one of the strongest, and the strongest in this war, one of the strongest in this war, is Yonko level. So I don't know how he's going to do that. Maybe he'll fight Kaido so many times, like with Crocodile, he'll eventually get up to that level. Maybe he'll alternate between Big Mom and Kaido and just like fight so much he becomes Yonko level. Maybe it will be some plot armored stupidity. I don't care if it's plot armored stupidity. That's not the point. The point is that Oda is going to make it happen. Because as I said in my last video, the man's getting tired of One Piece. He kind of wants to end it. He kind of wants to look over his work and be proud. He doesn't want to be writing this forever. He's been writing it for 22 years. So you can see he's wrapping it up. The series is coming to a head. And when a series is coming to a head, that means Luffy's got to get his performance up to be EOS Luffy. He's got to get his performance up to be the strongest. And what does getting your performance up mean? Becoming Yonko level. So that's all my reasons why Luffy is going to be Yonko level at the end of Wano, why he will become Yonko level at the end of Wano, and more specifically, why he will defeat Kaido 1v1. Becoming Yonko level, in my mind, the way Luffy has always done it, is to defeat Kaido. Or just, not Kaido, but the opponent of the arc, the main bad guy of the arc, he defeats them 1v1 and surpasses them. That's how it usually works in Shonen, especially in One Piece, and that's why Luffy's going to defeat Kaido 1v1 to become Yonko level, so the story can advance. That's it for this video, thanks for watching. If you enjoy my content and only if you enjoy my content, like this video, subscribe, and turn on notifications for more One Piece content, share this video if you found it interesting, and I will see you in the next video.